3 months back, I went to India, sent my family members, everyone. I said, I don't want to marry right in this situation, but my family members, everyone, they blackmail. So if you, that's not email, blackmail. If you aren't married, don't go to New Zealand, stay here, do for me. Okay. Then I'm okay. Okay, but I agree, everyone. Then I'm married there. Her name is Asha. She's coming from Hindu background. But I have no time that time. I didn't say anything about me completely. So when I come back here, then I realize I didn't say anything about my life and this type of scenarios, anything. If I say anything about church matters, anything, how he realize, how he accepted. If anything issue, in my whole family is the big issue. Oh, how he's going to church. He didn't say anything before me. Then I'm bit worried. But 2-3 weeks back, I got about my situation. She's very happy. She said, okay, you can go, no worries. Then I'm relaxed. Then before that, oh, God speak to Asha already. Then I'm relaxing. That's a big miracle. And second one is about my job. I came from Telugu background. Everyone knows my English is reading, writing, listening skills is very good. I'm honestly saying because I'm standing in front of the God. So last year I got the job. They conducted total 6 rounds. I don't know how I finished, but God is helping to win all the times. This first, second, third round is okay, HR and everything. In the 5th round, I got last 22nd of last month, I got call from HR. HR team, they said, okay, if all four rounds is clear, you are eligible to do in the 5th round. I'll send email. Then I'm open the email. In that email, that they are sending all the details and who participating. In that main person, like a CDO is participating in that interview. When that I'm open the website, I read about all his details. He's the second person of the company. Then I'm a bit worried, oh, how can I manage? Okay, he's a technical officer. So before that day, I'll read everything in my previous studies and everything. I wrote everything. In the midnight 2 hours, still studying and sleep 2-3 hours. Then I wake up, I read everything. So 11 o'clock is my interview. Before that, I go interview. I call Rajitana and David Uncle. They train and I say, Rajitana, Anna, I'm a little bit scared. Then Rajitana says, don't worry, Hari, God with you. You can go. So that day, is interview is 45 minutes. My interview started at 11 o'clock. But that CTO is very busy, some other works. My interview started at 12 o'clock. Okay. The interview is at 12 o'clock. He's asking only one question. Tell me about yourself. And some of others. Okay. And he's explaining his company details, everything, almost 15 minutes. But just I'm listening like this. I don't, because he's speaking like a Kiwi word, I'm not understanding that word. In the between times, I said, okay. In the between times, if he's this guy, I'm conducting the first or second round, I definitely fail. After 15 minutes, he said, okay, Hari, you pass. You can go now. Just I imagine. Last week, Hari, this how God will speak to some others in our matter. Then in the afternoon, I got a call from HR team. Okay, Hari, 5th round, everything is clear. So I'll send you contract papers, everything soon. Last Wednesday, they're sending contract papers, everything. Hari, everything is clear. You can come on Friday. You can put signatures on the papers. Friday morning, I went to office. They give all the papers. When I read the contract papers, I remember two persons first. One is David Amu and one is Rajitan. David Amu says, I think 2 weeks before he's praying for me regarding my job. Last 2 years I'm working morning 9 to till 11 o'clock, 10 o'clock daily, but I earning 400, 300, sometimes 500. So that, and David Amu says, okay, don't worry, I pray for you. But you know what he prayed? God, please give the good job. It's like a professional job. Morning 8 to 5, morning 9 to 5, like that job. You know, in that contract paper, they written the same thing. Okay, and second one, Rajitana says, pay you not all the money, like in the, my workplace, they give 400, 300. Don't worry, Hari. God definitely refills somehow. I didn't expect that much salary is given for us. They give 51,000 per annum. Then I'm surprised. Okay, then the last one, let me put the signature. One HR team day. You start on Monday, this Monday, tomorrow. I said, no, I can't because I have no work visa. I mean, I have no, before I'm working in a different company, I want to change my work visa. They said, no, if you don't want to start on Monday, your application is rejected. Then I'm thinking, God, please help me somehow. Then one supervisor came. I didn't say anything. He said, Hari, I'll give you the 2 weeks time. You go immigration and you can change the visa. Then I put the signature. This is how God has been in my life all the time. Praise the Lord. On Monday morning, I'm going to apply my work visa. Please pray for me, everyone.
He wanted me to translate. I don't think he'll be able.
Let us pray. Gracious Heavenly Father, we once again thank you for the kindness in Hari's life, Lord. Lord, miracles after miracles, Lord. And he has now fully trust in you, Lord. Lord, we want this young boy and his family should grow in you now, Lord. You have showed your mercy and grace to him, Lord. Now it is his turn to show the love to you, Lord. Lord, I pray whatever hindrance come, whatever obstacles come, Lord, remove, Lord, and bless him, Lord. When he starts new job, Lord, we look to your angel camps around him, Lord. Lord, any problem of language, Lord, I pray, Lord, bless him with the good language, Lord. And use this young boy for your kingdom, Lord. Lord, once again, thank you for Hari and his blessings. This we ask in the name of Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.
I would like to thank God for this wonderful day, a wonderful moment in our life. I would like to thank God for all his grace and mercy and love towards us. And he has been a faithful and a good father throughout all ups and downs in our lives. As we were in trouble with our visa situations in last year, in July. We almost packed our bags and we were ready to go. But immigration of New Zealand were very, all ready to kick us out from this country. But our God was with us and he was always with us. And he did a miracle and we are always standing here and we are able to celebrate his birthday just because of his grace and mercy and his hands in our life. And I would also like to thank God for Anand's life, and he has always blessed us with all the good things and always given us the best things, and he has been our hope. As the Bible says, for what do I wait, O Lord, for my hope is within you. And our hope was in him. And blessed us with his abundance grace, and for all that I thank God and praise him. Thank you so much.
And he is now so teacher.
Speaker.
Okay, this is also a miracle. We finished 12:30. Last prayer. Living Heavenly Father,